All right. Now, I've been doing a little bit of investigating, okay? Just a little bit. Because, you know, I had to find something. And I did. This hard drive, it contains all the dirt on Chris Chibnall. All the information one could possibly want to know about Chris Chibnall. This could take him down forever. And I now hold this information in my hand, right here. So, chibbers, sibbers, chicken dinners. Why don't you give me a call? You know, I'd hate for this stuff. Ooh, stuff's so juicy, so tasty to be leaked. And as for the rest of you, well, do not worry, people, do not worry. I have some entertainment lined up for you as well. They're unboxing videos, Doctor Who unboxing videos. Some of them date back months, in fact, all of them, I'm pretty sure, date back at least several months, but fuck it. If people watch them, give them what they want. Or at least what I can be at least half-assed to do. Anyway. This is Doctor Who Items to Unbox. I'm not going to say a number because then I can reuse this footage. How clever am I? Well, go on then. Is there something you're seeing I'm not? Go get watching, now! There's nothing more here to see. Just go in your little ways. Go and watch the nice little video. You know you gotta love it. Cause you better. Yeah, you better. Or else. And there goes my dog, and here is a package. Let us open. Good I did that, because I had the seller's address. Hooray! Yes, this is, slight crack on there though. Considering the price, really good. Ah! So this is Prisoner of the Daleks audiobook, read by Nicholas Briggs, which you know what that means. He's doing the Dalek voices in this. But yeah, I picked this up for, let's zoom in a bit actually, oh, you know what, smooth the Also, if you can hear panting, that is my dog. Because it is far, far, far too hot today, so yeah. But Prison of the Daleks, it's something I have a bit of nostalgia for because it's one of the few books that I have read. No, not just got two books, one of the few books in general because being dyslexic, you don't tend to read actual novels a lot. So I've read a fair few comics, but not novels. But yeah, Prison of the Daleks. From what I remember from when I read it, it seemed the first half was dragged on for far too long. And the second half was fairly good. Good knacks, I remember. I think I was just more proud of myself that I actually finished it. But yeah, read by Nicholas Briggs. And how many discs is it? Dear. But I picked this up for £3 on eBay, which is a really good price. And the delivery was fast and free. Let's take a look at this little booklet, shall we? Bruising of the Daleks. Some information that you can read just here. And some more here. Okay, so, wow, 5 discs. Yeah. It's going to be pretty long. I will be definitely burning. Burning? No, I won't. I'll be ripping the CDs. But, by the looks of them, they look in very good condition. So, yeah. Lovely javeling. Disc 5 will be there, and then there's some other ones in the range. And there's Mr. Briggs. Let's just zoom out and look at all the writing. And you have had time to read it. So yeah, lovely javeling in it. Okay. That was my dog whining about something. He's just happy to see me because I've just come in. Anyway. We'll watch him a bit more. Okay, he's done his thing. Anyway, onto this package. Which is from Amazon. It's Doctor Who Series 10 Steelbook Blu-ray. Wait, a lot of you will be asking, didn't you already do an unboxing of this? And the answer is yes, I did. And I still have it. So, why have you got another one? Basically, Amazon had one of their lightning deals, which lasted an hour, I think it was, or maybe an hour and a half. Where they were selling Series 10 Steelbook Blu-rays for £25. Which is great, because its regular price at the moment is, I think it's 56 quid or something like that. So I thought I might as well get another one, keep it sealed, and if I ever needed some cash and that, I could easily sell this to make the money, but it is nice to have a sealed up copy in that. But yeah, 25 quid with free delivery. Cannot argue with that. So most likely, probably gonna sell it someday, to be honest. Most likely when they stop producing these, when they've actually run out of stock, this will probably get sold and be able to buy something else. So yeah, I know that's gonna annoy and upset a load of people, but fuck off, it's mine, I can do what I like with it. I bought it, and also, weirdly, Amazon decided to do this lightning deal at 10 o'clock at night, 10 or 11 o'clock at night, which is weird, which is why they only sold, I think 25% by the time it ran out of the ones that they had on a lightning deal, which is, you know, the only reason I found out it is because the Doctor Who merchandise website had it advertised on there. Otherwise, this would have been a lightning deal that I never even knew about. It came just after Prime Day as well, which is weird. You know, if you think anything, you thought it would have been a Prime Day deal, but no, it was just one of their random lightning deals. So yeah, anyway, that's that. It is what it is, and hooray, hooray, day to day, komate, samie. This box is huge. Like, literally, I'm sitting about a foot or so away from it because it is just so big. So, actually, I'll put it flat. Will probably be best. Yeah, I think that'll work. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to place the camera here. I don't know why I never thought of this before, but hopefully you'll be able to see everything that is going on. So, yay, hooray. This bundle of stuff I got off eBay for £20. So just bear that in mind. How does it open? Ah! I think it's supposed to open from this side. That would be just a guess. God, my hay fever is in my eye. Ah! Or maybe not. Ah, wait, hang on. I understand now. One more time, people. I think this is how. Maybe. Oh, there's more tape. I think that's all of it. Shitty. Oh. Hooray! First layer. Can you see some stuff yet? Good. Let's start with some smaller stuff. A Toys R Us exclusive Supreme Dalek. You know what, I'm going to put the camera back to this side, just so I can see it. So yeah, Supreme Dalek from the Toys R Us box set, Dr. Dalek 2-pack. Eye stalk is bent a bit, no worries. It's an easy fix, put it in boiling water. It's a little bit dirty. Though that isn't an issue, otherwise in really good condition, just needs a bit of a clean. Yeah, I'm just having a look at this. Yeah, these things seem fine. So yeah, that's that. Leave the big thing for later. This is one of the main reasons I actually got it, was for a Revelation Garlic. Because I didn't have a one with the revised eye sculpt. Now this does have a bit of scuffs and that on it, unfortunately, but hopefully with a magic eraser I'll be able to get rid of that. So yeah, and again, bent eye sculpt, but again, boiling water works really well with this. But again, this was in the Dr. Dalek 2-pack range. Ooh. This is wrong. Should be again on camera it looks clean, but in real life actually it's a bit dirty. But this is obviously a character options character building Supreme Paradigm Dalek. This one with again a bent eye stalk. Ooh, really bent this one. Crucible Dalek with the Dr. Dalek 2-packs. This one looks surprisingly clean, actually. Normally they're pretty dirty, but this one is actually pretty clean, and the weathering actually It looks really nice because it's very, very subtle on this one. So actually, I think it looks really good, actually. Apart from the bent ice gulp, but again, can fix that. Now this is something fun, isn't it? This is a Dalek Sec air freshener. Now, I actually already have one of these. I've had one for years, but it's always nice to have another. I'm just wondering, does it still smell? I don't think so. Maybe the tiniest bit of hint. Though otherwise it's a new. Oh dear, this one is particularly dirty and will need to be cleaned. Yeah, very, very dirty. But will need to be cleaned up. And what is that on the socket? What is that? Let me have a look. Ah, I see. Okay, so clearly at some point this sucker has been snapped off and then glued back on like that. What I probably might do is just remove the sucker entirely and replace it in case it happens again, but yeah. But although I do have several of these Emperor Guard Daleks, this one is the one with the second Doctor. Ooh, load of dust on here. With the revised dome lights, the egg cup ones. Now, I already do have one, though it is sealed in its box, so it is nice to have a loose one. So yeah, very nice. Now, this was also one of the things. Can anyone tell me what the hell this thing is? I mean, I know it's a paradigm dump, but what is this? Because it's see on the bottom. Let me just give that a quick read. I think it's just copyright information. Yes, it is. But I don't know, were these for a board game or something? I mean, it feels too, if you know, it feels too solid, too well made to be one of them Doctor Adventures freebies. You know, cause it feels, it has a bit of weight to it, and it feels fairly solid. So if anyone can tell me what this thing is from, that'd be nice, because I have no idea. I mean, it's broken in any way, because you can see the eye is snapped off and the end of the plunger is gone. Well, I'd just be interested in where it was from. This was the one that I'd also liked, I wanted from it. This is obviously a Renegade Dalek, but it, again, this is dirty, really dirty. It's not showing up particularly well on camera, but these things are really dirty. They do desperately need a clean up. But again, this is the one I didn't have because I have the original one. In fact, I have two originals. But this one has the revised eye stalk and the revised slacks with the mesh. Unfortunately, they forgot to paint the slacks. Character options. Yeah, that was something, you know, they messed up on all of them, unfortunately. But they gave it the revised eye stalk. And I think it looks really good. Although the iris really should be less of a white and more of a silver. But to be honest, it's fine as it is. Oh god, my fingers are filthy off this. I can't really tell on camera. You can't really tell on camera, but I'm just running a bit of hand sanitizer on. Like, I could see from the pictures that a couple of them were a bit dusty, so I was expecting it, but I didn't realise how dirty some of them were. Another Dalek over here. Ah, I do have one of these as well. This is obviously a resurrection one with the which came with the fifth Doctor. Interestingly, the seller wasn't selling the Doctors that came with them like at all. They I checked on their page just to see if they were selling the figures that came with them, but no. I also checked to see if they'd already sold them, but no, they don't seem to be selling them. So either they're not selling them at all, or they're selling them at a later date. But here it is. Obviously, this one's got the orange Well, orange more of red. Orangey red dome lights. I do already have one of these, both versions. You know, the one with that, with the one with the standard dome lights and the one exactly the same as this, but it is not the one. I really do like this Dalek with the orangey red dome lights, really nice, and it has a nice vibrant silver on it as well. Lovely, lovely jubbly. Another Dalek over here. And this, I've got a few of these. Again, oh dear. The eye is clearly snapped off at some point and he's glued it back on. Though I might just leave this one because I'm not desperate for one. Because I've already got one, but yeah. This is just got an standard assault Dalek. Which, is that its full length? Or has it been snapped? No. No, this is its full length. I was just wondering if it, because I've seen a lot of them in the past where the end bits are being snapped off and they've just been pushed back in the hole, but no, that's, yeah, it is nice to have another one of these, but it's also a good point of comparison of this to this. And we've never had an assault Dalek in this revised sculpt, which is a shame. And, the way things are going, I doubt we ever will. I don't think there's any more loose Daleks in here. So let's get on to the big boy, which is bent. Ooh, there's his eye. Let's put his eye on. And the sun is going down. Unfortunately, it is a bit yellowed. Though for this Dalek, it sort of works because it is an Asylum Dalek. Let's click this eye back on. Come on. Hang on. I'm just going to have to take this off camera so I can. There we go. Click it in. And there we are. It's an Asylum Dalek. Let's just zoom in on it. See, I have all the dirt. This one actually is dirtier than my one. I don't mean in terms of it actually being dirty. Actually, this is probably remarkably clean compared to the others. But I mean the wash over it. Because on my one, the wash is very, very subtle. But this one, it's very heavy. And I think it just depends which, you know, one you get. I think in the run. I think some of them had much dirtier washes than others. I got mine when it was released, so I don't know if it's because mine was earlier in the run or if this one was later in the run, the original one I've got. So yeah, comes with its remote, and it feels, I think this has got a battery in it. It feels like it does, because it's got a bit of weight, so I'm guessing it must do. So 40 hertz variety, so most of my Daleks are 40 here. Oh, he's still got his batteries in. Good time to test him out, eh? Now go side. Maybe you don't, maybe this, it could have a dead battery in. Let's just see if the Dalek, if he talks, he should be a good sign. I reckon this thing just has a dead battery in it, most likely. Or if it doesn't, it doesn't matter. I've got plenty of these 40 Hz remotes and that, so that's all fine. Let's have a look. Is there anything else in the box? Oh yes, there is something. There's a red version of what we had before, which does have its eye stalk. Though he's missing its plunger. Come on. There we go. So yeah, there's the red one. Where's the blue one? So yeah. Fine. It's hard to hold them together because of the base, but if I can just get the camera in focus. You can see there. There they both are. Again, if someone knows what they're from, you know, please tell me, because I do not have the foggiest. So yeah, all of this for that was £22 including the delivery. But seriously, an amazing, amazing deal. And that's, and I'm going to mention this because it's become a running joke. Reese was very jealous. No, there's nothing else in that box. Good. Success. This way, his sucker's slightly bent. No, it isn't. Again. I'm going to have to put the kettle on after this and boil a load of water. Let's just put them all in shot as best as I can. So there they all are, all of them for £22. Really good price, really happy to have them all. Excellent deal on that for me. Obviously it's going to take me a bit of time to clean all these up and that. I might do a follow on bit, which might happen straight after this, where they're all nice and pristine again, but I reckon it shouldn't be an issue. Bada 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 bada. Alright, I'm going to be doing something different. I'm actually going to be filming the cleaning. Now normally I'd just use a damp cloth, though since there's so many that I need to clean, I thought I might as well fill up the sink, the bathroom sink, full of water. Should be enough. And let's just grab the dowel. Everybody. So there they are. Here's some of them. So let them submerge. And I'm gonna undo my cuffs. Roll my sleeves. I should have done that first, actually. Yeah. Go do just three at a time, just make it easier. I'm just going to be using some shower gel in this case. It doesn't matter. Doesn't matter as long as you use something. I'm just going to give it a nice scrub. You know, clean it all up. Make it so it is nice and clean again. And actually, you can see the dirt's coming off. It's shining in that. The Renegade wasn't that bad. It was mainly the slats. So, scrub that. I'm just rubbing it in with my hands just for quickness. Supreme, look at the shine now on those slats, much nice. So, I think we need a little bit more for the Supreme. These dogs are getting a bit of Old Spice for men. Because we've run out of soap for the upstairs bathroom. Got some in the toilet downstairs, but not up here at the minute. Because at the time recording this, in fact, actually, by the time you see this, I'll have been and gone to Blackpool, so we're not really buying any more things for the house just yet, because they're going away for a week to Blackpool, Liverpool and Manchester. That nice clean. Yeah, we're getting there. I think Supreme and Renegade are gone, so I'm just going to give them an initial wash off all the soapiness, make them all nice again.
It's important to keep, you know, I like to keep my Daleks clean. Actually, this water, yeah, this water is just about hot enough to bend the eye. Is it? Yeah, since this ice gog is smaller and also thinner, the hot water running through the tap is actually hot enough to bend the eye back into position. Just about there. So that's good, that means I do not have to turn on the kettle. Which is good because that saves time. And also saves money, obviously. Supreme Dalek. Yeah, that hot water is just about hot enough to start bending it. Actually, it's a bit of soap left over there. The trick to doing actually the ice stalks is to not push it so much as more as to pull it out, because that'll naturally straighten it out. Maybe a tiny bit of pressure, but there we go, that eye is pretty much straight enough, or as straight as I care at the moment, because I've already got one of these, so it's less of a priority to me. And finally this one, which I don't think had a bent eye stalk at all. Those slacks could do with a bit more cleaning though. Yes, I'm going to clean the slacks off. Let's give them a nice lovely wash. I'm going to really rub into that there. I could technically replace the slacks as well. Just wash the soap, keep water off. There we go, it looks much nicer. Now, I mean, these three do. Oh dear. I knocked the tripod, which is never a good thing. So I'll move on to, let's see. The bronze one doesn't really need doing. Yeah. The bronze one doesn't need cleaning, though I will use the heat from the tap to warm up the ice stalk. Just so it's hot enough to bend. So I get it nice out, and actually, naturally, it's bending itself back into place naturally because of the pressure of the water and the heat. See there? So if I just hold that like that, actually put it back into shape. And yeah, there we go. Nice and lovely, and means I can put the eye. There we go. The eye is back in the Dalek and it's now lovely, nice and straight. So good, that's another one. I don't know if the Resurrection Dalek was that dirty though, I'm going to clean it anyway, might as well. And the Revelation one, I need to get the magic eraser. Though I might as well clean it off first. Because cleaning it will also get rid of a bit of it. Just dunking them in soapy water like this is cleaning them immensely. But again, this isn't the way, this is the first time I've done it like this with multiple ones. Because normally I just use a damp cloth, maybe a bit of soap. Yeah, a bit of blue is come off already. What I reckon it's probably happened with that blue is it's hit against something. It's probably fallen off a table or something. Which is a problem with Daleks, they tend to roll off things. And it's most likely hit something that was blue. And the blue paint from whatever it hit has hit the Dalek. I would have done the magic eraser first. But I can't find where I put my magic erasers after the last time I used them, but I'll find them or just get some more. They're only a pound. Let's wash it off. It's took off a bit of the blue. And again, the heat can bend the ice sculpt into position. There's also a sound effect. There's obviously the sound effects version of this, but it's exactly the same. And to be honest, the sound effects for the character options 5-inch Daleks, not too fussed about them, to be honest. They don't sort of resonate with me like the Product Enterprise ones do. But yeah, his eye is straight again. And this one, does he? Let's give him a... Yeah, I don't think he needs any extra. I think he's perfectly clean. So I'll just give him a rinse. Just a note, boiling water, if you're dunking a Dalek in boiling water, this is not boiling water, this is just hot water from the tap. But if you are dunking a Dalek in boiling water or an ice dog, just note, if you leave it in there too long, it can take the glossy finish, if it has a glossy finish, off. I mean, you could reapply it, but that's just something to note. I'll go his eyes. Straight, and he looks all lovely jubbly. And now to leave them and all the other Daleks to dry. Push that down to let the water drain. So yeah, I'm debating whether or not he needs it. He is a bit dirty, a little bit, but I think I'm just gonna rinse him. Put a bit of the soapy suds on. I'll just clean him off a bit. Yeah, he wasn't too bad anyhow, but you know, with a bit of soap, comes off nicely. Oh, and by the way, if anyone has any spare Dalek parts, like, no matter what they are, you know, you want to part with them or you want to sell them to me, and that's, then let me know, because I'm always looking for odd bits and pieces, because sometimes I do get Daleks that are incomplete. Or ones, you know, that I've got broken bits here and there, so it would be nice. Yeah, if someone does have some spare bits and bobs that they can, you know, sell me or let me have or whatever, then please just let me know below. Yay. I couldn't find my magic eraser, so I used some of my mum's hairspray, which is the next best thing, and I got a bit of it off. Unfortunately, I did scrub a bit too hard and take a bit of the paint off just there. So that's irritating. A bit of the blue is off. I'll probably have to get some new magic erasers. But oh no, I took this battery out of the remote. A Toys R Us battery. These are going to become rarities, aren't they? I am tempted just to keep it because it has the Toys R Us name on it. But I probably shouldn't. But this battery was completely dead. I swapped the battery and the Dalek. It works fine. I can improve it as well.
The tripod seems to be stuck. Oh dear. But yeah. Move. Oh shit. I just bent my tripod leg. This is not good. Nothing is going my way now. I got this fabulous deal and now everything seems to be going shit. Right. Oh, turn on the Dalek. Be nice. Interestingly, the remote is being clearly it is being left in the sun, because the sticker on it with all the freezers, you can see there, is clearly being sun bleached. Again, this doesn't really bother me much. I've got loads of them, and the freezers are still easily seen. In fact, actually, they're probably even easier to see because it's made the background go lighter. So yeah. Yabby dabby do. I think that tripod leg is probably going to be alright. Yeah, it goes in there. Oh. It's not my day. I seem to be breaking everything. Everything I touch, it seems to break. Da 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 da. I realise sort of the irony here that this is probably enough to fill up an entire item screen box all by itself. Which it may do, who knows, but you will because you're watching Xbox. Yay. So, Bobby, what do you think of all this, eh? No comment? No? Okay, then. Well, here we have a package. Here we have a knife. Can you guess what I'm going to do next? First of all, there seems to be a bit of tape stuck to the end of the knife. Which is probably off the last unboxing. Gouda. So. Ooh. Ta-da! This is the power of the Daleks, the script. For it. So yeah, this is by David Whittaker, edited by John McCulloy? I don't know. I'm dyslexic. Anyway, a synopsis on the back and a nice image of a Dalek. And to be honest, this looks remarkably like the animated ones and the animated reconstruction of Power of the Daleks. Yet this thing came out, over a decade before. Apologies, my camera battery died, so I've swapped it out for a fresh one. So, yeah, anyway, as I was saying before, that looks... Seriously, that looks so much like Rob Ritchie's Dalek from the animated Power of the Daleks. Yeah, obviously. I'm just going to try and find the dip. Oh, look. Someone has wrote $2.95 on there in pencil, although I'll be able to erase it. Or should I keep it on there? But, okay. It looks like this came out in 1993, so more than two decades ago. So this book is older than I am, and it's probably older than a lot of you know in my audience, so yeah. But let's just have a look. Production credits. Okay, and there's an introduction as well. But what I want to do is, oh look, it does it by episode as well, episode 4.
Now, I want to go to the end of episode 5, because episode 5 has my favourite cliffhanger. Okay. Here we are. So, here we are. So,
Exterminate all humans, annihilate, destroy. Daleks, don't get and destroy. Daleks, don't get and destroy.
That's a great cliffhanger, and yeah, but I picked this up off eBay. It cost me £2, I believe, including the delivery, which, you know, it's excellent. So I paid £1 for the book and £1 for the delivery, and clearly they just sent it as most likely a large letter, you know, class it as a large letter. But yeah, just one thing. That image of Patrick Troughton really unsettles me. I mean, it's the eyes and that grin. It just looks really wrong. It's something about all their faces. I mean, Ben and Polly and that look a bit weird. But particularly Patrick Troughton, it just looks really weird. And also, something I'm wondering about is also this book is in excellent condition. Like, the only thing is, there's a slight ding on it there and there in the corner, but otherwise great. And the original price was $4.99. Obviously, back in 1993, and just for inflation, I imagine it would probably be about £6 or £7 today. Yeah, well, maybe not that much, but definitely at least a pound more. I'm interested, you know, of why they didn't put the picture of the Dalek on the front. I mean, it does say Power of the Daleks, but obviously, you know, Daleks is a great thing for advertising and that, so I'm curious why they didn't put it on the front. But, very, very happy to obviously have this Power of the Daleks. It might be my favourite Dalek story. As in terms of being a, you know, an actual Dalek story. Because Genesis of the Daleks, you know, I love equally. But the thing is, Genesis of the Daleks isn't, you know, it's about the Daleks, about their creation. But it doesn't really feature the Daleks at all. It's more about Davros and how he basically Rose could be basically destroying everything and that, but I do love Power of the Daleks, and I love the animated reconstruction as well. The animated reconstruction, you know, a lot of people give the animated reconstruction, you know, a lot of criticism, saying, oh, you know, this animation isn't that good. And that's like, seriously, people. But you do not appreciate how good you have it, a lot of these people. Because I imagine a lot of these people who saw Power of the Daleks animated reconstruction did not have to sit through, you know, previous reconstructions where it was basically just telesaps. Now, as good as Loose Cannon's reconstructions are, and they are, Loose Cannon does have the best unofficial reconstructions using telesnaps. But, you know, it does not compare to the animation. The Dalek animation looks absolutely excellent in the story as well. So, yeah. Anyway, just scare at a creepy, slightly perverted-looking Patrick Trunk face for a little bit longer. Tasteful.
No, I will. I'm serious. Don't even fucking think of getting the police getting involved. Come on. Yes, I'm being serious. Fine. If you get the police involved, who do you think they're going to side with? You or me? Huh?
Actually, oh. Camera skill on. Let's get this on camera, shall we, eh? Yeah, I'm going to put you on speaker. No. I will... Come on, let... Don't identify you. Really, don't identify you. I know you're protecting him. I know you are. Heck, I... Okay. I know Chris Chibnall has been hiding in my bushes. I know he has. Look, in fact... Yeah, if I look out in the gun, you look carefully. Oh, there he was!
He was just there for a second.
Yeah. No, I got it on camera. I've got the evidence. And you think you're going to get the police on me, are you? No chance. Look. Look. Okay. Just, here's the deal, alright? How about you just leave with him, okay? In 2019, eh? You know, maybe everyone can get their act here and maybe just have a nice taste feeling in the mouth after the shit you've done this year. No, it is. In fact, it's worse than being shit. It's fucking mediocre as hell, which is even worse. I mean, if you were bad, then at least that's something to talk about. If you're, like, spectacularly bad, you know, maybe you can enjoy it on an ironic level, but this is just boring dribble most of the time. Nah. Tell you what. No, not complying, are we? Right. Well, I know a Scottish person who's really gonna get you down, laddie. Yeah, I know that was awful, but I just thought of it out in the blue. Have you got any iron brew? No. Well, you're fucked then. Well, Reese, I've got a little address for ya, laddie, and you're gonna get done for murder for it. But hey, at least you're gonna save Doctor Who, aren't ya? Texting you the address now. It's gonna end, people. It's gonna be over soon. I promise you. It's gonna be over. I'll make sure it's over. See you on Sunday night, shall we?